Western world, religion ceremonies is particularly interesting to us young people. I was not raised Hindu. I'm a rarity in this faith. Pretty much all people who are Hindu in the United States, there are about 2.5 million of them and 15,000 Sikhs, are Indian extraction, and I'm not. I was raised Presbyterian. I think he said I was Methodist, but Presbyterian here in St. Louis. And then I had a class like yours in eighth grade, and I had a very significant experience after that that brought me to the faith, and then I've had other experiences since then which have shaped my beliefs. And I think coming to a religion because of your experiences is a much better, more powerful foundation for your beliefs than just taking a religion because your family asked you to be in it. The experiences that I've had, I guess you could consider mystical experiences. All of the religions have some place for mysticism in them. I run a center called the Living Insight Center. If you're in cross-country, I think you run past my center. It's over by the big Amoco sign. And I see students, I think, from your school running by during that time of year. We try to present all the world's religions there, and we're best known for a statue of St. Therese, the little flower. And you probably know that the Catholic Church considers her the greatest saint of modern times because people receive miracles when they pray with her. We've had over 1,000. We've had 43 infertile couples have children after praying there, and more than 500 people have seen the statue come alive, as many as 12 people at a time, including nuns. So many of the experiences I'm going to share, if we were a good share if we had more time, I would not have believed in. I was not raised in a tradition that would have made me think these kinds of experiences were real. And so that's all the more reason I believe in them, because I did have these experiences. Much of what I believe, again, I take as a matter then of my experience rather than just dogma, which is the case for many Hindus. Not all Hindus would have had the experiences that I'm going to share with you. To understand them, let me share a few of the basics about Hinduism. First of all, virtually all Hindus understand there's only one God. That God is infinite, incomprehensible, indescribable, formless, nameless. We name it Brahman, so we can refer to it, but it itself has no name. We can't describe it because it's infinite. Finite terms simply can't capture it. But if you're going to describe it, you could describe it as a sea of consciousness which is continually creating vibrations within itself that become patterned and dense, and that's the physical universe. And if you take that apart, it changes everything about how you perceive the universe and God and your relationship with it, because it means God did not create the universe separate from itself and then choose to be present everywhere in it, but rather absolutely everything is Word of God, including each of you in this building and all the things we don't like. Doesn't mean God is doing the things we don't like, but it means we're all part and parcel of that sea of consciousness that God is continually generating within itself. And if you take that to heart, you start experiencing and treating everything as sacred. When we greet each other, Hindus say namaste, which means the part of God in this form acknowledges the part of God in your form. Loving that enemy as thyself should be really easy. If you throw something in anger, you just broke God. Every thought and emotion you have is within God. If you have some burden that you have to deal with, writing a paper for this class, for example, instead of viewing it as a burden, if you can view it as an intimate interaction with God, because absolutely every part of the process is God, then maybe it becomes a sacred act and not so much of a burden. And Hindus believe that, and quantum physics tells us as well, that every particle of the physical universe is disappearing in and out of existence millions of times a second. You can see an atom, the parts of it are disappearing constantly. And Hindus say God is doing that, and God is doing that using a particular set of frequencies